I've given this puzzle, right? Did anyone solve this? New Python file. Okay. Or piglatin.py. I have asked you to create one function. Okay, right? So let me try to write that function. Okay, so def pig underscore Latin, and then you would be passing a word. So this method will return the big Latin word. Okay. Word to be, you can call it as encrypted to pig Latin. Okay. Word encrypted to pig Latin. Do you agree with me on this? Right. So what was the pig Latin? What is it I've said? If the word begins with AEIOU, you will add a way at the end of it. If it is a oval, if the word is oval, you will try to move the first word to the last, and then you will add AY. Yes or no? So shall I write the code for that? All right. Okay. If word of zero in AEIOU, then return format string of word and way. Okay, if that is not the case, then return format string of first letter to the end. Okay, this is what I want to, and after that word of zero and then AY. Sorry, AY should be out. AY. Is this a very difficult function, sir? This is what I have asked you. Now you tell me it is difficult or simple. You basically get, you will try to get lost into words, sir. Okay. Basically, what I've tried to do is I've tried to look into the English statement and then I tried to convert. In addition to that, I have used a comparison operator called as in, plus I have used slicing. And I'm quite sure that everyone in this classroom knows what a slicing is. We have done samples around it. Is this very difficult? Yeah. Now we will test this. Okay. So to test this, I'll go back to main.py and then I will try to import functions.piglatin and over here functions.piglatin.pig_latin. And what were the examples which we have used yesterday? If I type air, it should be written as airway. So print air. Eat. And then what else is I have written it as? What are the other examples? Python and computer. Python. Sorry. And computer. So since we want formatting to be friendly, I'll be using F string. Okay. And in the F string, let me use this. Okay. Years will become this. Okay. It will become this. Okay. Right. So that you get the whole context over here. Okay. Right. I think I missed something. Quotes. I have to close the quotes over here. Right. Now, shall I print this? Run. Main. So for air, did I got airway? For eat, did I got eatway? For Python, did I got Python pay? Computer K. Yes or no? Right? Good. Now, the next thing which I've asked is was for Pies, what do you call, Pig Latin sentence. Right? So what is sentence? Sentence is collection of words. Sentence is collection of words. Yes or no, sir? Right, so let me write that one also. If you have not done Pig Latin word, then I'm quite sure that you might not have done the Pig Latin sentence also. Sentence of sentence. Okay, now let me try to use the same thing. Okay. And rather than using the word, let me use sentence. Sentence to be encrypted. Sentence encrypted. Yes, sir. Now, at least this should be difficult, right? Okay, right. So let me write. Output is equals to. Okay. Let me put it as an empty list for word in sentence dot split. For word in sentence dot split. Okay. And then I am just trying to tell output dot append. What? Pig underscore Latin of word. Okay. Then at the last, I'll be trying to tell that return space dot join output. Okay. Now, shall we test this, sir? Shall we test this? So for testing this, we need some example, right? We need some example. Let me come up with some statement. Okay. This is test translation. Let me go with this. Okay. So I'm going to comment this stuff. Comment this one. And then print testing sentence. Okay, now sentence is equals to string of, let me use smaller cases. This is a test translation. Okay, so I have a oval, I have what do you call I have a oval over here, I have a oval over here, and rest of the things are not ovals, right? Now I will try to tell that print the sentence, okay, is going to become okay functions dot piglatin dot piglatin sentence of sentence. Now let me run this. So this is a test, T will be moved. This is way, A is a oval, so away. Yes or no, sir? Do you agree with me on this now? Was this that difficult as what you have been trying to? Right. That is the whole point which I'm trying to tell. Python, if you know how to basically deal, right, then it is very easy for you to solve, right? Solution. Yes. Yes. Okay, sir. Are we clear on this? Yeah. Now let me continue with Python functions. And at the last today also, I'll give you one puzzle if the time permits. If not, I'll give you tomorrow, because tomorrow you have 2 days of time to basically work out with. Right. So from Python 3, okay, it is possible, okay, to specify keyword only arguments, right? So let me try to basically write a very simple syntax, okay? So def print underscore colors, okay? And then you can tell color. Let me write Python over here. Python. Okay. And after that, you give a star. Star, the meaning of star over here is, okay, the thing that the single star in this function basically tries to tell you that the following parameters are named arguments. So let me try to tell start equals to 0. And end equals to 10. Okay. Now I'm not going to write the code over here, but what? Right. I'm just going to write a star in the function definition, okay, all right. Star in the function definition basically means that following parameters are keyword only arguments, okay, that the following parameters are named arguments or keyword only arguments, whatever you call it, okay. So let me quickly write the code for that. So new Python file, keyword only, right? So def print underscore colors of colors, comma, star, comma, start equals to 0, comma, and equals to 100, right? Now here let me very simply try to write for color in colors of start colon end print of color. This method, okay, is used to demonstrate name only or keyword arguments or named arguments. Named arguments, okay, right? Named argument start, named argument end, okay, colors, okay, right. Now what will it return? It is actually not returning anything, so let me remove the return statement. Now if I have to test this function, let me quickly write that if underscore underscore name is equals to underscore underscore main, then let me write some colors. Colors is equals to red, green, blue, yellow. I need some colors, some decent list. Orange, okay, purple, okay, right. Any other suggestions? Violet, yeah, thank you. Violet. Then if I write violet, I can write indigo also, right? Right. Yeah, gray, black. I have not written black. I have not written white also, man. White, black. That is more than enough. Now let us see how can I call this function. Okay. Calling this function is very much simple. Print underscore colors of, you can pass colors. Okay. So calling or the or, why should I write this? This is self-explanatory. And print underscore colors of colors, and then here I have to tell start equals to 2 and equals to 5 or end equals to 6. Am I clear on this, sir? Yeah. So or, okay, let me try to tell print colors, okay, colors, and then I have to give start or end, anything. I'll try to tell that my start is 3. Sorry. And now print colors, I'll give colors comma 1, 3. Okay, this is not something which we can, you might get an error when you do that. And here I am trying to tell that my end is equivalent to 5. Okay, now let me take this. Okay, let me try to, let me reformat this file first of all. I don't want to rename element. Okay, right. Let me copy this. And if you remember, we have created one file called as sample.py. So let me open Notepad++. And if I go to extreme end of it, sample.py for testing these kind of files. Okay, so it is in ctemp. Let me get into C drive. Ctemps Python. Python sample.py. Okay, right. Right. So one more thing. to make this look better, let us try to change the code slightly. Okay. Print. Okay. Start is 2 and end is 6. Okay. And print start is equals to 3. Okay. And over here, yeah, it has to be print underscore colors. Okay. Right. So here end equals to 5. So that it is easier for you and me to understand what is happening here. Okay. Right, sir. Now let me take this code, put it over here. Okay. And then let us try to run this code. Python sample.py. So first we have not given anything. So it has printed all of the stuff. Then we have said start equals to 2 and end equals to 6. Okay. Right. Then what has happened? Then it has tried to basically do that. Okay. Now we have given end equals to 5. Okay. Now let me see if I can do something over here. Print colon. Oh, just a moment. Let me give it a try. Just to make our life simple, this should. Okay. Right. I think that's okay. Have you understood what is happening? What is happening over here? Okay. The basic stuff which we have tried to do over here is we have tried to specify start and end arguments. Any doubts on this, sir? Right? Okay. So if you want to specify, okay, you can basically do that. Right. And let me try to do this. Let me try only this line. Think. Okay. Where is it? 1 minute, sir. I'll try to tell you what I was trying to do. Good. So generally what was happening, our lines were printing in every time in the new line, right? So if you pass this end equals to something, end means what will be the end line? By default, it will be a new line character. Now I'm changing it to space. So if you want, you can change it to comma. All right. So let me go over here. Where is that code? In Notepad++. End equals to comma. All right. Okay. Now let me try to run the same. It would be easier for you to understand. Sorry, saying? Okay. Is this much better, sir? Yeah. So it is not necessary that every time it has to print in the new line. You can change that. Okay. Right. Okay. Now, let me show you the sample code Python. And let us also have the output of it. Right. So Right. Copy the path of this and save it over here. 83. All right. Preview /images/python83.png. All right. Okay, sir. Now, let me speak about very much important notice over here. So, this is kind of a warning kind of a stuff. Okay. So, mutable and immutable arguments. Okay. So, let me try to write a very simple Python code. Okay. And you try to tell me what will happen when I try to do this. Okay. So, new file. Okay. Right. Mutable demo.py. Right. So, over here, let me try to basically do the same thing over here. Okay. Def change first argument or change first item. Okay. And then here I'll take items. Okay. This method will change the first item of a list to Python. Okay. So items, and what it will basically do, what it will basically do, let us try to look into it. Okay. Now over here, what I have tried to do is items of, okay, 0 is equals to Python. Am I clear on this? This is what I have said, that right? It will change the first item of your array always, always. Okay. We would basically try to add Python. So Kiran, I didn't got your problem. Do you have any problem with that? Any understanding over there? Okay, you are trying to tell about the previous program, keyword only. I've given start equals to 6. Yeah, sorry, here I've given start equal to 6, but here I have passed it as 3. That's the reason. Okay. Right. Thank you. Thank you for that. So let me correct that in the notes also. Start equals to 3. Okay. Output, I cannot change it, sir, because I don't want to run that program again. You please understand on that. Right. Okay. Right. So let me basically go to this mutable demo. Okay. So where is this mutable demo? Right. Now, okay, this is what I've done. Okay. Or for demonstrating this, you really don't need to do this also. Right. Let us go to our interactive Python. Okay. Python. Okay. Let me try to use courses is equals to DevOps AWS Azure. Okay. And then I've said def change first item. This is a function which I'm trying to write. And then right, let me create one more function. My bad, sir. Let me exit out of this. I have to take the arguments, right? Without taking arguments, nothing will end up. Right. Python. Okay. Let me write courses is equals to DevOps AWS Azure. So this is a list which I have. Now def change first course, and then I'll be taking some arguments. Okay. And then inside this function, I am trying to tell that 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh yeah. Arg of 0, the first course, I am going to change it to Python. Am I clear on this? Right. Now let me try to print courses. What is it I'll get? DevOps. Now I am trying to call change underscore first underscore course of courses. What is it I missed? Sorry, sir. My bad again. Okay. This time, if it doesn't work out, I'll try to write it in the code. Yeah. So I think courses is not working out for us. Let us try colors. Right? Yeah. Red, green, and blue. So I like white a lot. So def change first color of colors, or let me not use this. Colors might, you might get confusion over there. Okay. Let me write it as args. Okay. Now over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Args of 0, first color. Since I like white, I am replacing it with white. Right, sir. Any mistake in this? Yeah. Right. Now let me print colors. Okay. Now let me call change underscore first underscore color of colors. Okay. Now let me print colors. What is happening? Is your list changed? It is not a good idea to change some list. And if you are doing that, you try to ensure that you document that. That is the whole discussion which we are trying to have. So I have created a, this is a function. Okay. And after calling this function, the first value of the original list gets changed. Because why? Lists are mutable, right? Yes or no, sir? Okay. So it is a good practice to either document that argument may be changed or return the new value, or return the new value. Am I clear on this? Okay. So don't write functions as shown below. Am I clear on this, sir? You should document, you should at least inform the user that you are going to mess up with this list. You are going to mess up with this list. Remember deep copy? Yes, sir. So if you don't want to mess up with this list, please try to use deep copy. If it is okay to change the list, then basically be aware of this, right? So sometimes we might not think too much and we might use it, but the user of your method might not know about this. Might not know about this. Okay. Right, sir. So in Python, everything is an object. Do we agree on that? Yes, we have discussed about that object oriented and all of that. But functions are not left behind. Functions are, you can call them as first class citizens in Python. Okay, why? Because, right? Functions are first class citizens. Just because everything is in Python, it doesn't mean that Python functions don't have importance, right? Let me try to tell you. You can assign, or we can assign function to variables, use them as arguments to other functions. Not only that, and return them from functions also, right? So this capability basically gives to do some things in Python which are very, very difficult to carry out in many other languages, which are very, very difficult to carry out the stuff in other languages, right? So let me try to basically write a very simple function. Okay, so exploring functions.py. okay, right, sir. Now let me try to basically over here run anything. This is my function's name, and this takes an argument which is called as func. Okay, you can give any argument's name, argument name doesn't matter. Pass any function to it. Okay, function, right? Right now we are not returning anything, but I will just call. Am I clear on this? Yeah. Now I will very simply write a very, very easier program. Okay, so define, okay, pi. Okay, so what is the value of pi? Print 3.14. Okay, whatever it is, right? Okay, now this function prints pi. Okay, now let me try to write a very interesting code now. Okay, let me write. If this is something which you have been writing, if underscore underscore name is equals to underscore underscore init, then okay, what I would try to do is, okay, we have pi, right? Yes or no, sir? We have pi, which basically prints the stuff. Now I will try to tell that run anything of pi. Run anything of pi. Let us see what happens. Reformat. So what is that I have written? Just have a look at this code again. I have a function called as pi. I have other function called as run anything. For this, I am passing a argument, and then I'm calling this. Okay, now let's execute this stuff. Python sample.py. We have to save this. Sorry. All right. Oh, py run underscore anything. Define pi. Pi prints 3.14. okay, right, This should work. Am I missing something? Function can be passed as an argument. Okay, let me add this. Pi of. Intended. Man, I always mess this up. Right. Let me try this one out. Right. So, my bad. Why is it not printing? Oh. Sir. Sir, name is equal to init or main? You might have answered that. I might have done this foolishness. Right, sir. So is it printing 3.14? Now, if you look at this code, isn't it interesting? To the function, I am passing one more function as an argument. To the function, I am passing one more function as an argument. Isn't it interesting? Right? So this opens up, loads of capabilities. This opens up loads of capabilities in Python, right? So when we basically go into data sciences, when we try to write some, going sometime down the line, we'll be understanding something called as anonymous functions or lambda expressions, right? So then all of this becomes extremely interesting. Okay? Yes. So not only that, okay, there is also one more thing which you can do, right? Within a function, you can define one more function. Why will I do that? Okay, right? And then there are many other things which we can do with these functions. There are something called as closures and all of that stuff. So we need to still explore a lot about these functions, right? So tomorrow I'll be focusing on this area. Okay. So what are functions? From functions, how can you define another set of functions, right? What are these closures, right? And then we would be understanding something called as anonymous functions called as lambda. Right, we'll be getting into this area, and then we will be trying to understand something called as generator. Okay, so I don't want to stress up on these things. I will try to take simple examples. All right, let us not worry about it. Right, so for today, the only thing which I want you to know is Python functions can be passed as arguments. They can be returned. They do many interesting stuffs, right? Now, if you try to print this function, what is it we got? Sample.py, and then you got this. Right. Why I'm always running sample.py? Because every time I don't want to run the whole project, right? Right, sir. Okay. Now, what I'll do is, what we'll try to do is, let us try to do one thing. Let us try to basically think of one interesting solution in lists and tuples. Okay. So, we all of us have read what a list and what a tuple is, right? Okay, we know about sets, we know about dictionaries and all that stuff. Okay, so now here comes the exercise problem to you. Exercise one or exercises, I'll give more than one. Write a Python function which prints the first and last elements in the sequence. Yes, sir. I'm not asking very much difficult stuff over here. Okay. I'm basically asking very much simple. Okay. So, let me give examples. Okay. So, a sample output of this should be something like. Okay. Let me write tuple equals to 1, 2, 3. Right? And then first underscore last of tuple. First underscore last of tuple should basically print me. Okay. Or should give me the first element of the sequence and last element of the sequence, right? So if I print it out, so what I should get is, I should get an output of 1, 3. Similarly, okay, not only tuple, I might even pass a list to this. Tuple underscore sample. Okay, now list underscore sample is equals to 1, 2, 4. Now if I try to basically pass this, I should be getting 1, 4. Am I clear on this, sir? Yeah, Shiva, our whole discussion of function calling another function is something which we are going to discuss tomorrow. Tomorrow we are going to get into deep dive, okay, of that. Today I just wanted to give a introduction. A function can be passed as an argument. That was my whole discussion which I wanted to have. I want one function, sir. One function is enough. I don't want tuple function and list sample. I don't want. I want you to write one function which works for tuple and dictionary or list. Yeah, I'll stop it at that. Okay. So basically, try to solve or look into the functions. Look into the functions because these functions are important for us. Okay. And especially for the people who come from admin background, right? Okay. So after these functions, what you will try to understand is how can I write a Python program which can be used like a shell utility. So, or something like, I might write a Python program which looks like, okay, download, okay, underscore file, hyphen hyphen URL, some URL I'll give over here, and hyphen hyphen location. So when I try to do this, a Python code will be called which will take two arguments as URL and location and try to download that file into particular location. Or something like, I might write a program which is basically, okay, AWS underscore get underscore get EC2. Okay, we are getting EC2 instances, hyphen hyphen region. Okay, you might have written your account, so US West to something else. So where you write a Python function which is basically called when you execute this, which takes these kind of arguments. Okay, so initially we'll start our Python application building with command line applications. Sounds interesting, sir? So we are heading into that direction. Yeah, and then we will come back to classes. Right, because as a developer, you should be able to develop command line applications, UI based applications. Right, so first we will focus on command line applications. Right, sir, I'll stop it at that and we'll meet again tomorrow to continue this discussion.
Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe our channel and click on bell icon.